we'll go through the various environmental issues in various countries, that is the global environmental issues. First of all, what are environmental issues? So environmental issues are any such issues created due to human activities and cause harm to the environment. Very basic definition, right? So we know all these things that he's experienced throughout the world, not just our country, but throughout the world, the air pollution, the water pollution, right? Climate change. So all these things are already being experienced and the frequency has increased now year by year. Okay. For example, they have given an example, that is issues in Japan. Japan's environmental policy has reflected a slight balance between economic development and environmental protection. As the world's leading importer of both exhaustible and renewable natural resources and one of the largest consumers of fossil fuels, the Japanese government takes international responsibility to conserve and protect the environment. So major issue in Japan is related to the nuclear power. So Japan maintains 1/3 of its electric production from nuclear power plants. So, however, the Fukushima nuclear power plant disaster on 11th March 2011 proved the failures of nuclear power. 3 out of the 5 reactors in the plant started leaking following an earthquake in the nearby region. Over 140,000 people were evacuated from the nearby area. Now, this disaster, which happened, that is 3 out of the 5 reactors where the leakage was caused. So, this disaster was rated as 7 out of 7 on the INES scale, that is about the radiological emission scale. Okay, the international the radiological radiation, nuclear radiation emission scale it is. And 7 is the maximum radiation scale. So, it was rated as 7 out of 7. Also, waste management, that is the Japan's approach on waste management, relies heavily on 4 major factors. That is technological advancement in the incineration. Incineration in the sense closed burning, where any waste is burned in a closed container. Okay, so that is called the incineration. Technological advancement in plastic recycling, comprehensive production side recycle, stream package labeling, and wide consumer side or household participation and in recycling and waste material separation. But this waste management is also, like when we are talking about the global issues, there are different issues in different countries. So for Japan, when you say it is the radioactivity, that is the nuclear radiations, okay, because maximum of the electric power is dependent upon the nuclear power plant, and about the waste management. So these are the very 2 important issues in Japan. Likewise, when you talk about China, it has a lot more of environmental issues, like severely affecting the biophysical environment as well as the human health. Rapid industrialization as well as the lax, that is a relaxed environmental oversight. Lax, and this is a relaxed environmental oversight, have contributed to the problems. The Chinese government has acknowledged the problems and made various responses, resulting in some improvements, but the responses have been criticized as inadequate. Major issues in China are the deforestation, desertification. So China's forest cover is only 20%, which is very less. In 2011, Conservation International listed the forest of Southwest Sichuan as one of the world's 10 most threatened forest regions. Illegal logging and slash, that is cutting, deforestation and burn agriculture, consume up to 5,000 square kilometers of virgin forest every year. The use of disposable chopsticks that they use uses up 1.3 million cubic meters of timber every year. And desertification is one of the very major issues in China. Desertification is expanding at a rate of more than 900 square miles a year, fastest in the world. Approximately 30% of China's surface area is desert. The Gobi Desert in China increased by 20,000 square miles between 1994 and 1999, and the disaster is still increasing. Then cancer villages in China. The existing of cancer villages proves China's disregard for environmental protection. The cancer villages are large areas that are so polluted that even living in them can cause several types of cancers. in Changba, a cancer village, a city in southern Guangdong province, the river that flows through the town changes from white to a shade of orange because of varying types of industrial effluents like the cadmium, zinc, arsenic, etc. So that is because of the toxic effluents that are let into the river waters and natural sources. Okay, so those are carcinogenic. Okay, so though that is why those areas are called the cancer villages. Then there are a lot of issues in the Gulf countries as well. When we talk about Gulf states, they are referred to the six Arab states, that is the Bahrain, Kuwait, Oman, Qatar, Saudi Arabia, and the United Arab Emirates. In the last year, tourists have swum amid the raw sewage in these states. The purifying of seawater to feed the taps and the fountains is raising salinity levels, as you know, because there are no natural water resources much. There is all the seawater, and where desalination is done in order to bring those water safe for, you know, drinking and to feed to the taps. But these salinity levels, that is the salt which is removed, but it is increasing the salinity in other different sources. The simple basic of waste treatment and providing fresh water requires so much electricity that the region is turning into a nuclear future. Correct. So the major treatment is the waste treatment and the water, which is not available in those areas. So desalination plants require a lot of power, a lot of economic cost, a lot of power. Then land and soil pollution, air pollution, these are the other issues which are there globally. Then when you talk about our country, there are various issues in India as well. India has made one of the fastest progress in the world in addressing its environmental issues. Still, India has a long way to go to reach the environmental quality similar to those enjoyed in the developed economies. Pollution remains a major challenge and opportunity for India. All forms of pollution like the air, land, water, noise, etc. are prominently found in India. Floods are a significant environmental issue for is with the water and the sewage, the treated water and the untreated sewage. That are the major issues. That is a major issue, water pollution or improper treatment of the water or the sewage water. That is a major issue when you talk about our country. In detail, we will see about various issues in India. Like when you talk about globally, we just have seen that there are various issues all over the world. It's not just our country. But when you talk about our country, is the population, is the poverty, lower economic development. And that is why we could not completely address those issues, and those are increasing day by day. Okay? So, next we will see, when we had stopped with the environmental issues of India, so we will continue with the environmental issues, environmental and ecological issues of our country. Few of the environmental issues, when we talk about environmental issues, there are a lot more environmental issues. Few of them we will talk. The Stockholm Conference of 1972. So, the United Nations resolution for establishing the United Nations Conference on Human Environment of 1972 stated that there was a dire need of intensified action at national and international level to limit and, wherever possible, to eliminate the impairment of human environment. The Stockholm Declaration of 1972 has gone down in history as that global instrument which for the first time formally brought international focus onto sustainable development, a vital concept that remains fundamental to contemporary environmental regulation. So, talking about the Stockholm Conference is that these issues are being addressed from a lot, you know, from long back. It's not that it's not being addressed, or those are the issues that are coming forward, like they are being paid attention now. It's not like that. It's being paid, it was being paid attention in long back. So the Stockholm Conference of 1972, it was a meeting agreed upon a declaration containing 26 principles concerning the environment and development, an action plan with 109 recommendations and a resolution. The Indian Prime Minister Indira Gandhi, in her seminal speech in the conference, brought forward the connection between ecological management and poverty alleviation. It is to be noted that she was the only other speaker in the conference other than the hosting country Prime Minister. So that is being told to you because we as a country are being looking towards the environmental issues, are being paying attention to the environmental issue. It is not that those things were ignored. The Rio Declaration of 1992, the United Nations Conference on Environmental Development, also known as the Rio Summit, Rio Conference, or the Earth Summit, was a major United Nations conference held in the Rio de Janeiro, that is in Brazil, okay, from 3rd to 14 June 1992. The Rio Declaration consisted 27 principles intended to guide the future sustainable development around the world. So principle 16 out of the 27 principles emphasizes that national authorities should endeavor to promote the internalization of environmental costs and use of economic instruments in the sense like the fine, okay, taking into account the approach that the polluter should in principle bear the cost of pollution, like it happens in the industries when you a dedicated fine is given if you dispose your unpolluted water into the rivers if it is not within the standard limits. Okay, likewise, the classic polluter pays principle. Okay, so the polluter has to bear the cost. So that was declared, that was stated in the Rio Declaration in 1992. Period between 1972 and 1992. That is before this Rio Declaration. The period between 1972 and 1992 witnessed a number of tragedies. Like when you say Stockholm Conference, where certain issues were addressed, certain principles were declared. Okay. And then the declaration was on 1992. So in between this 1972 and 1992, a number of tragedies were witnessed throughout the world. Okay. The Bhopal gas leak in India in 1984. The Chernobyl blast resulting in radioactivity related injuries in 21 countries spread in Europe in 1986. The dioxin leak in the Seveso in Italy in 1986. The oil spill caused by the oil tanker Emoacadis in 1978. The Sandoz tragedy in which tons of toxic chemicals were washed into the Rhine River in Europe as a result of a fire at the Sandoz warehouse in Switzerland. All these and other heart-rending accidents highlighted the dangers of unregulated industrialization, as well as the fact that the environmental pollution knows no national boundaries. So there was a further centralization of environmental regulations, and the government decided to adopt a number of environmental protection agreements, especially to control the transboundary environmental degradation. And therefore, this Rio Declaration came into being. Okay, so in between 1972 to 1992, a lot of accidents, because the major industrialization took place in that particular period, that is 1972 and 1992. And increase in the industrialization, and that led to a lot of environmental issues which were ignored globally. It had no boundaries. Okay, so that is why again there was a need of the centralized meeting, which was the Rio Declaration in 1992. So what was the causes of such issues in that particular period? So some have cited economic development as the cause regarding the environmental issues. Others believe economic development is the key to improving India's environmental management and preventing pollution of the country. It is also suggested that India's growing population is the primary cause of India's environmental degradation. So this we are talking about the environmental issues in our country. So like what can be the different causes because of which these environmental issues are increasing in India? Well, systematic studies challenge this theory. Empirical advance from the countries such as Japan, England, and Singapore, each with population density similar or higher than India, yet each enjoying the environmental quality vastly superior than India, suggests that population density may not be the only factor affecting India's issues. So that is what we have. That is what it is being stated. Like when we say that the population is the major. The major cause of such environmental issues. But then there are various studies where countries having a large number of population density than our country and are still not affected by so much environmental issues. So it's not just the population which is causing a lot of environmental issues in our country. Of course, the population is increasing, but it's also the mentality, the awareness among the people, which is lacking. And the industrialization that we know, it is one of the major problems. Then, what are the major issues in our country when you talk about the environmental issues or the major issues in general? The major issues in our country are the growing population, poverty, agriculture growth, groundwater, developments and forests, degradation of the land, reorientation of the institutions, reduction in genetic diversity, urbanization, air pollution, water pollution, solid waste pollution, soil pollution, noise pollution, greenhouse gas emissions. So these are the various major issues of our country. When you talk about the population, it's the growing population. A population of over thousands of millions is growing at 1.51% every year. It puts a considerable pressure on its natural resources and reduces the gains of development. Hence, the greatest challenge for us, before us, is to limit the population growth. Although population control does automatically lead to development, yet the development leads to a decrease in the population growth rates. This environmental degradation ultimately reduces agriculture yields and food availability and causes famines, diseases and death, thereby reducing the rate of population growth. Then our next is the problem, major issue, that is the poverty. That is, India has often been described as a rich land but with poor people. The poverty and environmental degradation have a nexus between them, have a connection between them. The vast majority of our people are directly dependent on the natural resources of the country for their basic needs of food, fuel, shelter, and fodder. It's correct, right? We are majority of our country directly dependent on the food, fuel, shelter, and fodder, the natural resources. About 40% of our people are still below the poverty line. Environment degradation has adversely affected the poor who depend upon the resources of their immediate surroundings. Thus, the challenge of poverty and the challenge of environmental degradation are two facets of the same challenge. The population growth is essentially a function of poverty because to the very poor, every child is an earner and helper, and global concerns have little relevance for him. So these are actually interconnected. Population, if the population increases, the resources are not adequate, it leads to poverty, it leads to other environmental problems, right? Just give so so that one, that's what we were talking about, that this population, poverty, and then unavailability of the resources, then famines where there is lack of food provided to the people. So all these things are actually related to each other. Then agriculture growth. People must be acquainted with the methods to sustain and increase the agriculture growth with damaging the environment. High yielding varieties have caused soil salinity and damage to the physical structure of the soil. Whereas we know agriculture is the major contribution and the important factor of our country. But if the various causes like this disposing the in various areas, the effluents are disposed on to the directly land, the industrial effluents. So that causes even changing the physical structure of the land or pollution of the land or the land pollution causing the salinity. Okay, using this fertilizers, using the pesticides, causes salinity in the soil. So then that reduces the quality of the agriculture growth as well. The economic contribution of agriculture to India's GDP is steadily declining with the country's broad-based economic growth. Still, agriculture is demographically the broadest economic sector and plays a significant role in the overall socio-economic fabric of India. And therefore, efforts have to be made in order to not affect the quality of the agriculture growth that is happening in our country. Then groundwater. It is essential. So it is essential of rationalizing the use of groundwater. Just a second. Factors like community waste, industrial effluents, and chemical fertilizers and pesticides have polluted our surface water and affected the quality of the groundwater also. So that is maximum, groundwater is used. Groundwater of our country is being used a lot more as relation to the surface water, of course. Surface water, we could actually see the surface water which is polluted, but groundwater we could not see, but much of our groundwater is polluted, has declined because of the seepage of the industrial effluents, because of the seepage wherever the solid waste is disposed, the landfills. So seepage of the waste from that landfills through the ground into the groundwater has caused a groundwater pollution to a higher level. It is essential to restore the water quality of our rivers and other water bodies as it is an important challenge. It is so finding that are suitable strategies for consecration of the water, that is the preservation of the water, provision of for safe drinking water and keeping water bodies clean, which are difficult challenges, but are essential. The suitable strategies for such preservation of the water, provision of the safe drinking water and keeping the water bodies clean, these are actually required. In developments and forests. So forest cover, very important factor. Forests serve catchments for the river with increasing demand of water, plan to harness the mighty river through large irrigation projects where we. This would submerge the forest, displace local people and damage the flora and fauna. Example, the dams on the river Narmada, Bhagirathi and elsewhere have become areas of political and scientific debate. But it should not be on the cost of the forest land, of course. The forests in India have been shrinking for several centuries owing to the pressure of agriculture and other uses. Vast areas that were once green stand today as wastelands. These areas are to be brought back under the vegetative cover. The tribal communities inhibiting forests respect the trees and the birds and the animals that gives them sustenance. So when you talk about forest cover, it's not just the green land. It's all related to the birds and the animals and the other species that live there. We must, and also the people who depend upon the natural resources living in the forest. We must recognize the role of these people in restoring and conserving the forest. The modern knowledge and the skills of the forest department should be integrated with the traditional knowledge and experience of the local communities. The strategies for the joint management of the forest should be evolved in a well-planned way. Okay, so these are the few issues. There are a lot more issues. We could keep on talking about them, but few of the major issues related to the environment, okay, related to the country, so that were just shown to you. So that is one of the small part in your first module that is related to the environmental issues. So you have the global environmental issues. Of course, globally, a lot more issues are happening, and the environmental issues of our country. Just give me a second. I show you a video related to it. Yeah. Further, I'm sorry, we'll continue with it. There are a few things still remaining, then I'll show you the video. Okay. Further, there is reduction in genetic diversity. further few of the issues we'll still go through, and then we'll see a video on it. Reduction in genetic diversity. At present, most wild genetic stocks have been disappearing from the nature. Wilding, including the Asiatic lion, are facing problem of loss of genetic diversity. The protected areas, network like sanctuaries, national parks, biosphere reserves are isolating populations. So they are decreasing changes of one group breeding with the another. Remedial steps are to be taken to check the decreasing genetic diversity. So if you separate these wild groups, so there is the change in the genetic or reduction in the genetic diversity. Then urbanization, nearly 27% of India live in urban areas. Urbanization and industrialization has given birth to great number of environmental problems that need urgent attention. So we know when we are living in urban areas, so we know what are the problems. Over 30% of the urban lives in slums. Out of India's 3,245 towns and cities, only 21 have partial or full sewage and treatment facilities. Right? Matlab, we have so many towns in the urban areas, but only like very, very, very few people have this proper sewage facilities, proper water treated water they get. Okay. Whereas maximum people live in the same areas where there is no proper sewage facilities, no proper treatment facilities. Coping with the rapid urbanization is a major challenge. Then air pollution, the major problem. Air pollution in India is a serious issue, with the major sources being fuel, wood and biomass burning, fuel adulteration, vehicle emission and traffic congestion. Air pollution is also the main cause of the Asian brown cloud. Asian brown cloud is a phenomenon that's happening. Okay, which is because of the smoke, because of the pollution, the clouds have become brown and the cover is now affecting the climate change, because it will not, because this brown cloud will not let the sun rays to reach the earth. Okay, so which is causing the monsoon to be delayed. India is the world's largest consumer of the fuel, wood, agriculture waste and biomass for energy purposes. Traditional fuel, that is the fuel, wood, crop residue, dung cake, dominates domestic energy use in rural India and accounts for the 90% of the total energy. Vehicle emissions are another source of air pollution. Vehicle emissions are worsened by fuel adulteration and poor fuel combustion efficiencies from traffic congestion and low density of quality high-speed road network per 1,000 people. So you know the traffic congestion and the vehicle emissions. The Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act, which was passed in 1981 to regulate the air pollution, and there have been some measurable improvements. However, the 2012 Environmental Performance Index ranked India as having the poorest relative air quality out of the 132 countries. This is the 2012 data. Even if you look at the recent data, our country is in the list of the most polluted countries. In water pollution, a 2007 study found that the discharge of untreated sewage is the single most important source of pollution in the surface and the groundwater in India. So the major source of pollution of the surface water sources and the groundwater is untreated sewage. No proper treatment of sewage, and it is let down directly into the groundwater. It goes to the groundwater, seepages to the groundwater, but it is disposed of directly into the surface water. We have a very good example of the Mithi Nadi that is fully polluted because of the untreated sewage that is let into the river water. There is a large gap between generation and treatment of the domestic wastewater in India. The problem is not only that India lacks sufficient treatment capacity, but also that the sewage treatment plants that exist do not operate and are not maintained. The operational maintenance is not proper. In 2008, the water quality monitoring found almost all the rivers with high levels of BOD. BOD is the biochemical oxygen demand. That is, that actually indicates technically, BOD indicates the toxicity in terms of organic contamination. Okay, when BOD levels are high, the water or the sewage is highly polluted, highly organically contaminated. Okay, rivers like Yamuna, Ganga, Gomti, Ghagra River, Chambal, Mahi, Vardha are among the other most coliform polluted water bodies. So coliform is the bacteria which actually causes the you know, the epidemics like cholera and all. So those are actually formed, actually caused by this disease-causing bacteria, which is one of the bacteria called coliform. Okay, and when coliform is there in the water bodies, it is an indication that your water bodies are polluted with the fecal matter. The flooding during monsoon worsens India's water pollution problem as it washes and moves the solid waste and the contaminated soils into the rivers and the wetlands. So wetlands, the rivers which were useful, the wetlands which are a lot more useful, okay, those are getting polluted because of such problems. And solid waste pollution and solid waste disposal, which is a major problem. Trash and garbage is a common sight in urban and rural areas of India. It is a major source of pollution. In the country, the solid waste produced every year is 226.6 million tons, and Indian cities alone generate more than 100 million tons of solid waste every year. Street corners are piled with trash. Public places and sidewalks are despoiled with the filth and litter. Rivers and canals act as the garbage dump. In part, India's garbage crisis is from the rising consumption. India's waste problem also points to a stunning failure in the governance. In 2000, India's Supreme Court directed all Indian cities to implement a comprehensive waste management program that would include household collection of the segregated waste, recycling, and composting. These directions have simply been ignored. No major city runs a comprehensive program of the kind envisioned by the Supreme Court. Very few, if you see, very few actually cities are paying attention to this solid waste problem. Whereas there are things that are imposed, segregation, proper collection of the waste. There are things that are told, but not followed yet. Then soil pollution. Soils in India can be classified into 8 categories as alluvial, black, red, laterite, forest, aride and desert, saline and alkaline, and peaty and organic soils. In March 2009, the issue of uranium poisoning in Punjab attracted press coverage. It was alleged to be caused by flash ponds of thermal power stations, which reportedly led to severe birth defects in the children in the Faridkot and Bathinda districts of Punjab. So what happened is, the thermal power stations in the nearby area of the Punjab, the fly ash ponds of thermal power station, byproduct of the thermal power station, that is the waste that is formed, are the fly ash that is formed. It is the waste that is formed by the burning through the thermal power stations. And this fly ash ponds, which was directly, you know, disposed of on the land or on the surface water sources, then have caused a lot of defects. The news reports claim that the uranium levels were more than 60 times the maximum safe limits. In 2012, the government of India confirmed that the groundwater in Malwa belt of Punjab has uranium metal that is 50% above the trace limits set by the United Nations World Health Organization. Scientific studies based on over 1,000 samples from various sampling points could not trace the source to fly ash and any sources from thermal power plants or industry as originally alleged. So when originally it was told that fly ash was it's coming from the thermal power plants, but still, by testing the various samples, there are other sources of fly ash as well. The uranium, which is a part of fly ash, so there are different sources from which it is led into this natural water sources or the soil. The study also revealed that the uranium concentration in the groundwater of the Malwa district is not 60 times the WHO limits, but only 50% above the WHO limit in 3 locations. This highest concentration found in samples was less than those found naturally in groundwaters currently used for human purposes elsewhere, such as the Finland. So research is underway to identify natural or other sources of uranium. So uranium, which is found in the different, not just the water source, surface water sources, but on the land, but on the groundwater sources. So still the researchers are going on to find the sources of uranium in these areas. Noise pollution in India is quite a big problem due to excessive use of horns for no sensible reason whatsoever. If a person is to hear horns of such high volumes throughout the day, then naturally, as age advances, hearing will become difficult and will slowly lead to deafness. This too can be eradicated slowly but steadily through education. People need to understand that honking so much and that too unnecessarily is harmful and not safe. The Supreme Court of India, which is in New Delhi, gave a significant verdict on noise pollution in 2005. Unnecessary honking of vehicles makes a high decibel level of noise in cities. The use of loudspeakers for political purposes or for the other beliefs like other rituals have created noise pollution in various areas. In January 2010, Government of India published norms of permissible noise levels in urban and rural areas. There are standards of noise level given, but followed and then maintained is the problem. Maintaining it and following it, and that becomes a problem. That is a problem in our country. And greenhouse gas emission. So greenhouse gases are those gases which can absorb and emit the infrared radiation, but not the radiation in or near the visible spectrum. In order, the most abundant greenhouse gases in the Earth's surface are, or Earth's atmosphere are, water vapor, carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, ozone, CFCs. Actually, these are the gases which are responsible for maintaining the temperature of our country. Our country would have been a solid ice. Okay, but the temperature is maintained in our country because these are the greenhouse gases which are responsible for absorbing the rays of the sun and maintaining the temperature. But if these gases are increased in their quantity, the greenhouse gases now are increased in their quantity. So it leads to large quantity of absorption of the sun rays and large increase in the heating of the earth. Okay, so India was the third largest emitter of carbon dioxide in 2009 at 1.65 gigatons per year after China, which was 6.9 gigatons per year, and the United States, that was 5.2 gigatons per year. With 17% of the world population, India contributed some 5% of the human source carbon dioxide emission compared to China's 24% share. On per capita basis, India emitted about 1.4 tons of carbon dioxide per person in comparison to the United States of 17 tons per person and a world average of 5.3 tons per person. So this greenhouse actually gas emission, that is a problem all over the world. It's not just our country. And it is affecting globally. The complete earth is being affected by it. So that was all about a brief describing about the various issues, environmental issues of our country. I'll show you a video related to it.
Pollution of air, water, and soil require millions of years to recoup. Industry and motor vehicle exhaust are the number one pollutants. Heavy levels as it faces the shortage of resources like water, fuel and food. The population explosion in less developed and developing countries is straining the already scarce resources. Intensive agriculture practiced producing food damages the environment through the use of chemical fertilizer, pesticides, and insecticides. Overpopulation is one of the crucial current environmental problems. Number 4. Natural resource depletion. Natural resource depletion is another crucial current environmental problem. Fossil fuel consumption results in emission of greenhouse gases, which is responsible for global warming and climate change. Globally, people are taking efforts to shift to renewable sources of energy like solar, wind, biogas and geothermal energy. The cost of installing the infrastructure and maintaining these sources has plummeted in the recent years. Number 5. Waste disposal. The overconsumption of resources and creation of plastics are creating a global crisis of waste disposal. Developed countries are notorious for producing an excessive amount of waste or garbage and dumping their waste in the oceans and, less developed countries. Nuclear waste disposal has tremendous health hazards associated with it. Plastic, fast food, packaging and cheap electronic wastes threaten the well-being of humans. Waste disposal is one of urgent current environmental problem. Number 6. Climate change. Climate change is yet another environmental problem that has surfaced in the last couple of decades. It occurs due to rise in global warming, which occurs due to increase in temperature of the atmosphere by burning of fossil fuels and release of harmful gases by industries. Climate change has various harmful effects but not limited to melting of polar ice, change in seasons, occurrence of new diseases, frequent occurrence of floods and change in overall weather scenario. Number 7. Loss of biodiversity. Human activity is leading to the extinction of species and habitats and loss of biodiversity. Ecosystems, which took millions of years to perfect, are in danger when any species population is decimating. The balance of natural processes like pollination is crucial to the survival of the ecosystem and human activity threatens the same. Another example is the destruction of coral reefs in the various oceans, which support their rich marine life. Number 8. Deforestation. Our forests are natural sinks of carbon dioxide and produce fresh oxygen as well as helps in regulating temperature and rainfall. At present, forests cover 30% of the land, but every year tree cover is lost amounting to the country of Panama due to growing population demand for more food, shelter, and cloth. Deforestation simply means clearing of green cover and make the land available for residential, industrial or commercial purpose. Number 9. Urban sprawl. Urban sprawl refers to the migration of population from high-density urban areas to low-density rural areas, which results in spreading of the city over more and more rural land. Urban sprawl results in land degradation, increased traffic, environmental issues and health issues. The ever-growing demand of land displaces natural environment consisting of flora and fauna instead of being replaced. Number 10. Ozone layer depletion. The ozone layer is an invisible layer of protection around the planet that protects us from the sun's harmful rays. Depletion of the crucial ozone layer of the atmosphere is attributed to pollution caused by chlorine and bromide found in chlorofluorocarbons, CFCs. Once these toxic gases reach the upper atmosphere, they cause a hole in the ozone layer, the biggest of which is above the Antarctic. The CFCs are banned in many industries and consumer products. The ozone layer is valuable because it prevents harmful UV radiation from reaching the Earth. This is one of the most important current environmental problems.